3D printed LEGO bricks? Sound like a great idea, right? Well, it's more complicated, but it can be done. After all, we just printed this huge LEGO Prusa factory. It took us over 847 hours of printing and we used almost 5 kilograms of filament. Before we go into how to print bricks compatible with original LEGO, let's take a quick tour of the factory with our LEGO Joe. First, we enter the warehouse, which is full of boxes with printer parts and those sweet, sweet Haribo gummy bears. From there, let's continue to Prusament manufacturing lines. This is where we produce our own filaments with the perfect winding you all love. The famous printer farm is located on the second floor of the Prusa Tower. This is where plastic parts for our printers are manufactured 24/7. And what's on the third floor? Well, it's Joe's office, but we're not gonna follow him in there. He needs to focus on inventing more cool new 3D printers. Instead, let's take a look at how to print LEGO compatible parts properly and what are the advantages and disadvantages of 3D printed bricks. First, you should keep in mind that the printed bricks will never be as accurate as the original LEGO parts. But you can still produce nice and usable pieces that will connect not only to each other, but also to the original LEGO sets. This way, you can print missing or special pieces that LEGO either does not offer at all or sells for a very high price, such as large base plates. And what is the cost of 3D printed LEGO parts? If you print them with PLA, the material costs are about one-third of the original LEGO piece price. But you will have to do some post-processing, which takes time. The most important thing needed to print LEGO parts successfully is to have a properly calibrated first layer. Otherwise, you'll struggle to connect two pieces together. So let's try to print some bricks with our original Prusa i3 Mark 3S. First, we need to pick a good model and adjust a few settings in Prusa Slicer. Place the brick with its bottom resting on the heated bed, then go to Print Settings, Advanced, and set the elephant foot compensation to 0.4 mm. Then enable Brim, but keep Support Generation off. And that's it, let's print a brick! Keep in mind that FFF 3D printing is not ideal for printing small parts such as miniature hands for figures. Instead, try to use it for printing large special pieces such as base plates and railroad parts. In fact, railroad parts were the best pieces that we managed to print successfully. They don't require such a high level of accuracy and they are a lot cheaper than the original ones. Also, you might ask why don't we use our original Prusa SL1 to print detailed parts? That's a great question, and in fact, the SLA technology is perfect for that. You will probably not be able to print large pieces with the SL1, and common bricks may be prone to abrasion, but for printing LEGO minifigures and other detailed parts, it works really well. So even though printing a LEGO-like brick is not as easy as pushing a single button, and some additional work is usually required, it can be done with pretty good results. We uploaded our models to prusaprinters.org, so you can enjoy them too. So go ahead, print and build something amazing. And as always, happy printing!